Your job is to align. Your job is to enjoy this miracle of a ride called life with full presence, with full awareness, with full joy and enthusiasm that comes when you're capable of aligning yourself consistently and therefore also deepening your presence in this present moment experience of this now miracle that is your reality. Right? So you get to align. You get to say how good this life can feel.
Welcome to the Untethered Entrepreneur, a community of disruptors who use business as a vehicle for personal growth and global contribution. We take 100% responsibility for the world we live in, and that's why we're the ones creating the change we wish to see for ourselves, our communities, and our larger global family, humanity. Stay tuned for personal development, fast growth business, and leading edge wisdom to support you in living as the Untethered Entrepreneur. Cheers to unlocking your limitless potential.
Hey, what's up, my friends? Noah Hammond, Tyrrell here, and I'm so excited to be discussing with you today the real secret of success, which I call the law of alignment. And I'm particularly excited if you're here, if you've been studying the law of attraction, applying it, doing your best to better yourself, achieve your goals, visualize success, become it, believe it, achieve it, succeed, and all these things, because honestly, the law of attraction and a fundamental misunderstanding of the law of attraction led me to a place that I could call nothing else but rock bottom. It led me to an efforting and efforting and efforting without a receiving that was so emotionally taxing and really left me with my hands up in a place of surrender. And from that place, the guidance that I needed is what showed up. And that's what I want to share with you today. So first thing that I want to talk about is why the law of attraction is fundamentally flawed in the way that it's being taught. Not that the law doesn't work, it's just being taught incorrectly, in my opinion. And my opinion might matter because I used to be a law of attraction teacher myself. I've studied dozens of books on the topic, I listened to countless speeches on the topic, studied the top thought leaders in that space. And here's what I can tell you. It's a real simple misunderstanding, actually. And it took me years, for whatever reason, to see it for myself. The simple misunderstanding comes, in my belief, from the word attraction. If you look at the word attraction, it has the word act in it. It has the word action in it. It has traction in it. These are all very action-oriented, doing-oriented type words. And without a really crystal clear understanding of the law of attraction, how it's really working, we tend to think that we are these master manifestors and we can create whatever reality we want. And so we have to do more, achieve more, focus more, believe more. Oh, I attracted the bad. I need to attract more good. What am I doing? How can I change myself such that I attract the good? And it literally will lead you into burnout and exhaustion. And that's why I think the law of attraction should actually be taught more precisely as the law of alignment, which is the true secret of success. And it's what I'm going to teach you right now. And again, for those of you who are already studying the law of attraction, I'm glad you are, because the way I'm going to teach you the law of alignment is directly from a woman named Esther Hicks, who is one of the probably the most successful law of attraction teachers in the world. And so from her vantage point, with my clarification of wording, here's how the law of alignment works. In a recent talk that I listened to from Esther, where she's talking about the art of allowing, she uses the analogy of a river often, right? That life is this river, this moving current of water. And if it was actually that, and we got in, we put our boat into the river, we would never imagine that turning the boat upstream and paddling with all our might upstream would be the way to get anywhere valuable. But that's a lot of what we are actually doing in this life. And the simple way to know it is if you're paddling upstream, things feel negative, things feel bad, things feel like tireless or endless obstacles or anything like that. And if you're paddling downstream, or at least you have the boat turned downstream, you don't even have to be paddling, you feel in flow, you feel good, you feel joyous, you feel appreciative, you feel the expectations of success, you feel like the success is already here, you feel motion, you feel movement, you feel alive. So the simple way to know if you're paddling upstream or downstream is to check in with your emotions. It's your emotional guidance system, right? This is nothing new. Here's what I never understood up until now, that I think just the simple way of calling it the law of attraction is what led me to misinterpret. you have to understand what your role is as a human being versus what you're doing from your higher self, from your source self, from your source consciousness, from the part of you that is fundamentally intertwined with the creator of all creation, right? If you want to think about it from a metaphysics perspective, you could look up quantum entanglement. And from that perspective, you know that all things are entangled by a tangible force. So whichever piece of you is entangled to the oneness of all creation that is creating alongside with you and sort of orchestrating your reality from a higher self, you might call it intuition, you might call it the universe, you might call it God, you might call it source, you might call it an inner knowing or gut instinct. That part of you is the creator. That part of you is the manifester. That part of you is the doer of all, creating all synchronicities and all opportunities and all synchronistic alignments and the fundamental experiences required for you to achieve that which you desire. Now, this is the critical distinction. The higher self is the doer. The you in your physical body, the part of your consciousness that is focused in physical reality, that is here to experience contrast in duality, hot and cold, light and dark. I like this. I don't like this. I want more of this. I want less of that. I like more of this. I'll have some more of that. Please no more of that. More of this. The part of you that's here in physical reality experiencing contrast, its job is simply to experience. Experience contrast, fire off desires, experience, fire off desires, and align downstream, right? The higher self, that's the current of the river. That's the bends of the river that exist four bends down that your human self can't even see yet. That's the creator, that's the manifester. The physical self is the steerer of the ship, the experiencer of reality. And the part of you that has the say as to whether or not you're going to ride this ride with joy, enthusiasm, appreciation, and gratitude, or if you're going to ride this ride like it's living hell. The human part of you gets to determine that. Think about it literally quite like an amusement park ride, right? You can get on the scream machine and look forward to the loops and the bends and the turns and the flips and the scary thing that happens right before you drop down with enthusiasm and excitement, or you can be terrified. You can be angry, you can be fearful, you can be annoyed and angry throughout the whole ride because I hate roller coasters, right? It's totally up to your human to decide which experience of life you have. So again, the fundamental distinction though is the human doesn't decide what gets manifested, your higher self does that. Your human self is simply responsible for experiencing, navigating, and aligning downstream and following the flow. And not fighting the flow, but steering to navigate the flow with your highest good and highest awareness and highest consciousness. And your human self is responsible for firing off desire because that comes from this leading edge experience here in three-dimensional reality. But it's not responsible for the creation of those desires. It's simply responsible for paying attention to how the human self is feeling and following the cues that align you to be your higher self. That's why it's the law of alignment. The law of alignment is the one that you pay attention to. That's the true secret of success. So the first thing that comes to mind for me, at least as a high achiever, as a doer, as self-actualized being is like, won't this make me lazy? No, in my experience, it won't. And I'll give you a direct example. Several years ago, I used to train Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu about 6 days a week, usually 6 days a week, and usually 2 to 3 hours each of those days. And I train hard and I train for competitions. And whenever there was a competition, I would sign up for it and I would compete and I would train even harder for the competition. And when I was injured, I would come to class anyway and sit and watch and mentally improve instead of just taking the time off to heal. And all of that felt joyous. Was it hard? Was it work? Was it effort? Absolutely. And it felt amazing. I loved it. Now, contrast that with several years later where I wasn't as consistent with my practice. And I also had the story constantly going in my mind of like, I should be practicing more. I should be practicing more. What is that? Well, what that is riding this ride, this river ride with my human self, jiu-jitsu was downstream for me. And I was joyously efforting to practice it 6 days a week with intensity and focus. Eventually, that consistency of practice became upstream for me. And because of my attachment to the way things were, I kept trying to turn the boat upstream. I should be practicing. I should be doing this. Why am I not? And that feels negative. And so you can see that things that used to be downstream from you sometimes move upstream. And you can either turn to try to get upstream and feel negative and start to create a lack of momentum in your life, or you can recognize that your human self is not to say how it all goes and be the manifester, the creator of your reality, but to simply recognize what's occurring via your emotional guidance system and to align with that which feels good, that which brings you energy, that which expands you into a greater version of yourself, because they're one and the same. So my encouragement to you is to click the link below this video, because on my site, I put together a complete list of structural ways in which we get triggered and out of alignment, reasons why we turn upstream, as well as a very complete list of tools I've used to realign myself back downstream. It's literally a dozen in each category, so I'm not going to go into all of it in this video. The awareness that I want you to leave this video with is simply the fact that the law of alignment is the true secret of success. Your job is to align. Your job is to enjoy this miracle of a ride called life with full presence, with full awareness, with full joy and enthusiasm that comes when you're capable of aligning yourself consistently and therefore also deepening your presence in this present moment experience of this now miracle that is your reality. Right? So you get to align. You get to say how good this life can feel. And the tools, the techniques, and the awarenesses that'll help you see like why we get out of alignment and how to get back into alignment, those are available on my site below. So click the link. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, subscribe. Drop me a comment below. Let me know if this has been helpful. I know for me, this cleared up such a fundamental misunderstanding of how the law of attraction is applied. So much so that I think the law of alignment is really the way to call this thing and the way to treat this thing. And I've seen instantaneous results of increased flow, increased synchronicity, opportunities flying my way since making this change just very recently. So I hope that it brings that same level of momentum and joy and expansion into your life. I hope that if you're consistently trying to swim upstream in some sort of way that you see that and you see the ineffectiveness of that and you start to look instead, how can you align versus how can you quickly create this result that you think is in your highest good, which ultimately nothing upstream is in your highest good. So that's it for today. Tons of love your way, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye for now.